Frankly, as my dog, he loves the streets of New York as much as I do.
Although he likes to eat bits of pizza and bagel off the sidewalk, and I prefer to buy them. Brinkley is a great catcher, was offered a tryout on the Mets farm team, but he chose to stay with me so that he could spend 18 hours a day sleeping on a large green pillow the size of an inner tube. Don't you love New York in the fall? It makes me want to buy school supplies.
Oh.
I'm almost ready.
I would send you a bouquet of newly sharpened pencils if I knew your name and address.
I need a double today.
On the other hand, this not knowing has its charms.
Did you push it?
Yeah. Yes, I pushed it.
I'm so late. Random House fired Dick Atkins. Good riddance. Murray Chilton died, which makes one less person I'm not speaking to. Hurry, hurry, hurry! Ugh! Vince got a great review. He'll be insufferable. Tonight, pin dinner.
Am I going?
Joe Fox, you promised.
It's black tie.
Oh.
Can't I just give money instead? I mean, what is it this week? Free Albanian riders?
Oh,
so I'm in favor of that.
Oh.
Okay, I'll go. I'll go. You're late.
Oh, I know, I know.
Dear friend, I like to start my notes to you as if we're already in the middle of a conversation. I pretend that we're the oldest and dearest friends as opposed to what we actually are. People who don't know each other's names.
Morning, Mr. Fox.
And met in a chat room where we both claimed we'd never been before.
Is the electrician here today?
See, I just told you he had a deer, man. I knew you weren't listening to me.
Right. I wasn't. I hear nothing. Nothing. Not a sound on the city streets, just the beat of my own heart. I think that's how it goes, something like that.
You and Patricia got engaged, didn't you?
You can tell me.
Engaged?
Come on.
Are you crazy?
What? I thought you liked Patricia.
I do. I do. I love Patricia. I love Patricia. Patricia's amazing. Patricia makes coffee nervous. Hey, you know what? We should announce ourselves to the neighbors. Let them know. Here we come.
Well, no, this is Upper West Side, man. We might as well tell them we're opening a crack house. They're gonna hate us. As soon as they hear, they're gonna be lining up
to pick at the big bad chain store
that's out to destroy
everything they hold dear.
Yeah.
Do you know what? We are gonna seduce them. We're gonna seduce them with our square footage and our discounts and our deep armchairs and
our cappuccino.
That's right. They're gonna hate us at the beginning, but
we'll get them in the air.
You know why?
Why?
Because we're gonna sell them cheap books and legal addictive stimulants. In the meantime, we'll just put up a big sign. Coming soon, a Fox Book Superstore and the end of civilization as you know it.
Good morning, Christina.
Good morning, Kathleen.
It's a beautiful day. Isn't it just the most beautiful day?
I guess, yeah, sure.
Hey, what are you doing?
Don't you just love New York in the fall?
What is going on with you?
Nothing. You're in love.
In love?
No, no. Oh, yes, that's right. I'm in love with Frank. I'm practically living with Frank. Well, do you think you could get our Christmas mailers out this week?
Oh, yeah, by Monday, I promise. I have this paper due Friday. What is going on?
Nothing, nothing, nothing at all.
You know, I am just gonna stand here until you tell me.
All right. Is it infidelity if you're involved with someone on email?
Have you had sex?
No, of course not. I don't even know him.
I mean cyber sex.
No.
Well, no, don't do it. Because the minute you do, they lose all respect for you.
Mm. Well, it's not like that. We just email. It's really nothing. On top of which, I am definitely thinking about stopping because it's getting
out of hand.
Confusing. But not because it's nothing.
Where'd you meet him?
Oh, listen, I can't even remember. Okay. On my birthday, I wandered into the over 30 room for a joke, sort of. And he was there, and we started chatting.
About what?
Oh, books and music, how much we both love New York. Harmless, harmless, meaningless bouquets of sharpened pencils.
Oh, excuse me.
Forget it. We don't talk about anything personal, so I don't know his name or what he does or where he lives exactly, so it'll be really easy for me to stop seeing him because I'm not.
God, he could be the next person to walk into the store.
I know.
He could be... George.
Morning.
Are you online?
Well, as far as I'm concerned, the internet is just another way of being rejected by a woman.
Good morning.
Good morning, Birdie.
What are you girls talking about?
Cyber sex.
I tried to have cyber sex once, but I kept getting a busy signal.
I know. I know. I was really depressed one Saturday night about 9.
Time to open up.
I thought, no problem. I'll just go online.
Oh. Jessica and Maya, how are you today?
Want to say hi to Kathleen?
Hi, Kathleen.
Hi. Hi. Shop around the corner. George speaking. May I help you?
Construction's going well. We should open on time, although Kevin and I are both a little concerned about the neighborhood response. Hey, this fabric on the couch, what is it? Does it have a name?
Money.
Huh?
Its name is Money.
Oh, Jillian selected it.
Good guess.
Your father's getting married again.
Really?
Yep.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Why?
Who knows?
Love?
Possible.
I think you're a damn fool.
Pops, Matthew is 4 years old, okay? It would be nice for him if he knew his parents were married.
Listen, I have a sad announcement to make. City Books on 23rd Street, it's going under.
Oh, another independent bites the dust.
On to the next.
You're gonna buy out their entire inventory of architecture and New York history for the new store?
How much, son? How much you paying?
Well, whatever it costs, it won't be as much as that exquisitely uncomfortable mohair episode there, which is now all over my suit.
Here you go.
Thanks. We're also going to have a section dedicated just to writers who've lived on the West Side.
As a shot to the neighborhood.
Perfect. Keep those West Side liberal nut pseudo-intellectual
readers,
bleeding
Dad,
hearts.
Readers, Dad. They're called readers.
Don't do that, son. Don't romanticize them. It'll keep them from jumping down your throat.
Well, what's the competition?
One mystery store, Sleuth, 78th and Amsterdam, a children's bookstore. Shop around the corner. It's been there forever.
Cecilia's store.
Who's that?
Cecilia Kelly. Lovely woman. I think we might have had a date once, or maybe we just exchanged letters.
You wrote her letters?
Oh, mail. That was called mail.
Stamps. Honorable.
You know, I've heard of it.
Well, Cecilia had beautiful penmanship. She was too young for me, but she was enchanting.
Enchanting?
Her daughter owns it now.
Huh. Too bad for her.